Hi, my name is Julia. I'm a program manager on the Visual C++ team at Microsoft, and today I'm going to show you how to create and attach to a remote development container in Visual Studio Code for your C++ projects. Let me quickly show you what the environment setup looks like when you are developing inside a container in Visual Studio Code. So you'll open Visual Studio Code on your local machine. So in this demo, I'll be opening it on my MacBook Pro. And that's where the VS Code client is running. That's where my source code lives on my MacBook laptop. And then when I attach VS Code to a container, VS Code server, along with extensions for my project, such as the C++ extension and the CMakeTools extension, those will all be running inside the development container. My source code will be mounted from my local machine into the container. And my debugger, my compiler, all of those build tools are in the container. That's where my build, run, and debug environment is. The theme and UI extensions in this local OS part of the diagram, those are things like your color themes so that you have your local quality development experience regardless of where you are building and debugging your program. For this demo, I'm going to use a simple C++ Fibonacci program. So I'm going to open that in VS Code on my MacBook Pro. And the first thing that you're going to want to do to connect to a remote container in Visual Studio Code is install the Remote Containers extension, which you can do in the marketplace. There we go, looks like this. Once you have this extension installed, then if you open the command palette and type remote containers, you'll see all of the commands provided by the Remote Containers extension. So I'm going to select Add Development Container Configuration Files because that's the next step for opening our project inside of a container. And I'm going to select C++, and for the distribution, I'll do Ubuntu 18. So what did this just do? What this did is it created this .devcontainer folder in my project directory, and there are two files in that folder, devcontainer.json and a Docker file. So the Docker file describes the image that will be used to spin up the container. And because I selected C++ as my development environment, the Remote Containers extension gave me a sample Docker file for a C++ development container. And you can see what the contents are for this sample file by clicking on this link. It's on GitHub. And as you can see, it just installs a bunch of C++ build tools. But you could change the contents of this Docker file. You could bring a different Docker file into this project. This is totally customizable. In devcontainer.json, this is where you specify things like the extensions that you want to be installed inside the container. So by default, we have the CPP Tools extension or the Microsoft C++ extension listed here. And again, that was just provided by the Remote Containers extension because I selected C++ as my development environment. I'm going to add the CMakeTools extension because I have a CMakeList script in this project, and I'm using the CMakeTools extension to build and debug my Fibonacci program. So let's save those changes. Some other things that you can do in devcontainer.json is specify additional local file volume mounts. So you can add the mounts property, for example, if you wanted to specify additional mounts between your local and target file systems. Okay, so now that we have our devcontainer.json file and our Docker file, that's all VS Code needs to open this folder in a remote development container. So if we open the command palette again, then we can select Open Folder in Container, opening the Fibonacci folder. And this is starting up our development container. And you can tell that you are in your development container by checking out this green rectangle in the bottom left corner. We see here it says Dev Container C++. Okay, so now that we are in our development container, we should be able to build and debug our project. And we can check to make sure that we have all of our C++ build tools installed in our container, things that were outlined in that Docker file, which we do. So in order to build and debug using CMake tools, the first thing that you need to do is select a kit. And here, all of these commands in the blue status bar at the bottom, these are provided by the CMake tools extension. And this one here that says GCC, this is the kit that I'm using, which basically is just the compiler that we want to be using. And if you select that from the status bar, a list of compilers found on the computer will appear. So these are compilers found in the development container. I'll select GCC. And then let's do a clean reconfigure. Configuring done. And now let's build and debug our project. So I'll just select this build icon from the status bar. And to debug our project, let's set a breakpoint. Oh, looks like we already have one set. So we can hit this debug button. And this is asking me to enter the number of terms. So if we go to our terminal, let me put in 10. And now we are in our debugging session. We can step through our program. You have your local variables, you have your watch variables, your call stack, breakpoints. So once again, you're getting that local quality development experience, even though it's using GDB inside of the container and running my program inside of the development container. So I just showed you how you can create and attach to a development container in Visual Studio Code. But let's say you already have Docker containers running and you want to attach to those existing Docker containers, regardless of how they were started. You can actually do that too in Visual Studio Code. So in order to do that, just open up the Remote Explorer and make sure you have containers selected at the top here. And then these are development containers that I've created with Visual Studio Code. But if we collapse that, you'll see other containers. So these are other Docker containers that you have running, and you can attach to those by clicking this Attach to Container window icon. You could also do this from the command palette and select Attach to Running Container. Thanks for watching this quick demo for how to develop C++ projects inside of a container using Visual Studio Code. Be sure to check out all of the live sessions at Pure Virtual C++ on May 3rd for some more C++ content. Thank you.